Good evening, everyone, and welcome back to JWE Monday Night Jayromada. We are coming to you live from Green Bay, Wisconsin, where tonight we are on the road to the Against the Odds pay-per-view event coming up in just a couple of weeks. Will Akechi's flawless streak continue through tonight? Can A2 maintain her iron grip on the women's division? These are some of the questions on the universe's mind as we head into tonight's show. This is Jayromada. And for our first match of the evening, introducing first, it is Kanji Tatsumi. From Japan, weighing in at 160 pounds, Kanji. Kanji, I believe, still looking for his first win. I'm not entirely sure. He might have had a win that I just forgot, but certainly not doing super well this season. But every match is a new match, so hopefully he will get another one if he already has one sooner rather than later. I'm waiting with bated breath, though. And his opponent, it is Mr. Money in the Bank, the Lone Wolf, Senkichi Hasegawa. Having pretty much the opposite season that Kanji's having, doing quite well for himself, and biding his time to see when will be the best time to cash in his briefcase and have a chance at the title. Here we go, both competitors set. Bell rings and we are off, with Senkichi immediately beginning the offense with a punch and a headlock uppercut. Thought he was going to go for a suplex there, but nope, quite. Elbow drop twice. And he waited, made us wait a little bit, but there's the third. Now right hands and face plant into the mat. Now kicks to the sternum, and Wolf starting off very strong here. But Akanji getting out of the way of that attack, and sending Wolf for an Irish whip into a spinning slam. A very early pin here, and a very early one count. Senkichi with the hip toss into the arm-breaking elbow drop. Now Senkichi back up onto his feet, but another Irish whip, but whiffed on that. Rolling neckbreaker, though. And Kanji getting a little bit of momentum back. Stomp to the face, and stomp to the back of the head, and Kanji, is he letting out some of his frustrations of just not able, you know, just being unable to get a whole lot going on? jumping forearm from the top rope to the outside, connects, and now picking Zenkichi back up and throwing him back inside the ring. But Zenkichi stepping back out, immediately punished though with that side angle slam by Kanji into a jumping elbow, but Zenkichi immediately up onto his feet and immediately sending Kanji down to the mat, just laying him out with that punch. Now kicks to the chest and the clothesline, and even more stomps. And now trying to send trying to send Kanji back into the ring, but apparently not. Zenkichi getting the better of that clutch with an Irish whip, diving down and a rolling back elbow. And another delayed elbow drop. Zenkichi getting his rhythm back. Picking Kanji back up, walking him to the corner, but Kanji elbowing out. Now a clothesline. Slipping that. Now sending him over the top. And one more powerbomb. Now going for the pin. One, two. Wolf kicking out, but Kanji, he might be finding a strategy here. Picking Wolf back up and sending him over the top rope onto the apron. And now, middle rope suplex from the apron. I didn't know he had the strength. One, two. Zenkichi kicking out, but again, Kanji might be finding a strategy here. Picking Wolf up onto his shoulders and facebuster and another pin. I'm not going to be surprised if this is a rope break though. Nope. Zenkichi rolling out. Kanji picking Zenkichi back up, but Zenkichi with that reversal, whipping on that punch though, allowing Kanji to get the better of the clutch and that spinning back elbow off the redirect. Now stomps to the face. And now Kanji climbing up top, top rope here. High risk maneuver with no payout. Zenkichi in kind with that double leg drop kick into the Wolf's Bane. Well, not quite the Wolf's Bane, excuse me. Somehow connecting on that diving axe handle. And a leg drop, or excuse me, a knee smash into the mat, and some right hands there. Now picking Zenkichi up by his long curly hair and tossing him into the ropes. And now from behind, delayed suplex. And now some right hands in the ground and pound. And Kanji, all the momentum is in his corner right now. Putting Zenkichi up onto the apron, dragging him ankle onto the ropes and face first. Rolling elbow drop. Thought Wolf was going to get out of the way of that, but nope, Kanji connects. Now working on that neck. And Kanji looking for the finisher, but Wolf getting out of the way of. Nice reversal. And now suplex. Picking Kanji up. And here we go. The Wolf's Bane. picking Kanji up and taking him down. Pin attempt, a little bit too close to the ropes for my liking, and there we go. As soon as I say that, Kanji with a very smart rope break. And here we go, Wolf with another Wolfsbane attempt. Same time, same place, connects. Okay, not same time, but same place. Again, a little bit too close to the ropes for my liking. Kanji instead deciding to kick out this time. Now Zenkichi in the corner looking for Kanji to get back up onto his feet. The double clotheslines into the jumping rebound clothesline. And a stomp to the hand twice, why not three times? And a choke slam into the corner. And another pin here, this might be it. One, two, and Zenkichi surviving and winning, continuing his streak, and Kanji putting up such a good effort, but Wolf was just a little bit too strong for him. But I don't think Kanji should be feel too disappointed about that match. He did fairly well, especially against Mr. Money in the Bank. The Zenkichi with another win to his total, and he's one more away from a shot at the championship belt. One more closer, excuse me. And our next matchup, introducing first, it is the ex-mistress of Jayromada, or JWE. Losing it last week to Maki Harukawa, and now, because of the rules of the Nexus Championship, she cannot get it back. It is Aigis. And her opponent, it is the swordswoman from the future, hero of, if I always forget where Awakening takes place, I'm so sorry. It is the masked warrior, Lucina. Warrioress? Anyway, it's Lucina. Not making many appearances so far, but every time she has put up an exceptional fight. And I'm sure that tonight will be one of those. Here we go, bell rings, and Aigis immediately beginning the offense, but Lucina with that reversal, Aigis pushing her away, and continuing that offense with the reversal, Aigis pushing her away, and again, jumping shoulder barge. and neither competitor wanting to give a single inch to the other in the opening. Lucina with some nice right hands there, and then bringing Aigis down. Now kick to the lower back, not really sure how much that's going to hurt Aigis, with her being a robot and all. Nice! Springboard stunner, and then landing face first against the mat after that suicide attempt. And that is why it's called a suicide maneuver. Already up to a three count, and Aigis climbing in. A very fast count here from the referee. Aigis climbing up top. Is she looking to go around the world again? No, she jumps off. High kick into the back heel kick by Lucina. And it was stomped to the leg. But Aigis kicking Lucina off of her. And tilt-a-whirl. A takedown, but Lucina with a nice block. An Irish whip to the northern ropes. And another takedown there. And now Lucina going for a pin. One, two. Aigis kicking out, but it's looking a little bit rough for her. Lucina on the outside. Is she looking for the phenomenal forearm? No. A phenomenal DDT. And another pin attempt here. One, two. Aigis again kicking out. Double leg drop kick right to the back of the head. And Lucina taunting Aigis. As now Lucina is climbing up top. Diving elbow to the back. Now both competitors to the outside. Lucina looking to continue the offense with that frog splash that connects. And now kicking Aigis in the back. And again. Now picking Aigis up onto her feet. But Aigis with a very nice reversal. Kick, spin kick, and face full of metal joint right there. Now tossing Lucina back inside the ring, climbing in herself. Yes, I thought she was looking for an apron attack, but nope. And Aigis somehow connecting on that. Now takedown into a sleeper chokehold out of nowhere. But Lucina getting her off of, or getting Lucina off of her, or Lucina getting Aigis off of her, excuse me. Spinning back elbow. And now a pin attempt from Aigis. One, two. Lucina kicking her off. Dropping elbow. And picking Lucina back up. But Lucina with a very nice reversal. Looking for the uppercut, but no, Aigis grabbing her into the snap suplex. Lucina looking to roll out, but Aigis stopping her. Now Aigis, top rope. .540 shooting star press. Connects. And now dragging Lucina. That looked like a very awkward landing. I'm not sure who was hurt more. One, two. Lucina getting her shoulder up. She will not be defeated today, at least. Not at this moment. Both to the outside. Aigis, her pathfinding program bugging out a little bit there. Allowing Lucina to stand up and toss Aigis back inside. Lucina rolling in herself. Springboard frog splash connects. Not going for the immediate pin. Dragon screw takedown. And now a knee to the back of the thigh. And Lucina, outside apron. Phenomenal DDT attempt, but Aigis getting out of the way and hitting her with that double leg drop kick. And now Aigis again, top rope. Turning around and another 540 shooting star attempt, but Lucina getting out of the way and a double leg drop kick. Both getting out of the way of each other's respective signatures. Splash attempt there by Lucina that connects from the middle rope. Now kicks to the face. Now Lucina again on the outside apron. And another phenomenal DDT. This one connects. 1, 2. Aigis getting her shoulder up. Now Lucina continuing that offense, but Aigis with that reversal. Hip toss-ish. Into the double leg dropkick right to the spine, and again, but this time to the side of the chin. To the jawline. Sending Lucina down. Now working on her leg. Pushing her down, going for the pin. 1, 2. Lucina getting her shoulder up. Aigis just showing off there. Lucina with that dropping elbow. And Lucina, is she looking for another phenomenal DDT? Phenomenal forearm this time, but missed. Back elbow. But I guess with a very nice reversal. And it's still up in the air. Takedown into the leg drop. But I guess with a nice reversal, very back and forth. I would be at the edge of my seat if my microphone wasn't directly in between my legs. Reversal into that snap mirror, into the running leg strike, excuse me. And now Lucina again looking for a phenomenal attack, a DDT this time, and another pin. 1, 2, and Aigis not gonna kick out of this one, and we finally have a winner, and that winner is Lucina. It's a very back and forth, extremely entertaining match. That could have gone either way, but Lucina just hitting that phenomenal DDT. And despite not participating in many matches this year, as of yet, Lucina putting up yet another phenomenal victory and showcasing her skills. And we might be seeing more of her in the future. And our first tag team match of the evening. And you know, I'm gonna be very upset at the end of this. Introducing first, it is the Double-Edged Blades. Kyra and Mithra making their way to the ring here. Looking to put on another match. I wouldn't necessarily say phenomenal or fantastic or even good, because this is a tag team match and this game has no idea how to do those. Yeah. Maybe I'm putting the cart before the horse here. but we have seen some pretty good tag team matches. Hopefully this will be one of those. And their opponent, it is the Double Dragons. Yuki Koamagi and Chie Sadonaka. I think it's Sadonaka. Here we go, Pyra and Yukiko, with 20 minutes on the clock, bell rings, and Pyra thought she was looking for an immediate pin, but nope. Yukiko going for the immediate submission attempt, but Mithra breaking that up. Now Yukiko going for a pin, but Mithra distracting the referee just enough. Pyra getting her shoulder up. And a distinct, shall we say, beginning to this match. Now some work on that neck and now slamming her head down. And kick to the back. And now Yukiko tagging in Chie. GA spin kick missed. Throwing Pyra into the corner, running kick, but Pyra getting her hands up just in time to block. And now snap suplex. And tagging in Mithra. Nice dodge there by Yukiko, connecting with that spin kick, low kick. And now going for the pin, I wouldn't be surprised if Pyra does not go for the pin for the breakup. Kicks there. And dropping DDT. And now tagging Yukiko back in. And Yukiko, I think she was thinking of attacking Pyra, but thought Mithra was the better target, and now going for a pin. 1, 2. And again, Mithra kicking out. The strategy must be just continue going for the pins, because that's what they're doing right now. Now taking Chie back in. Excuse me, I almost said Yukiko. That is Chie. GA picking Mithra up and sending her down with that punch, and now tagging in Yukiko. Mithra looking for a tag. Yukiko unable to get the attack in before she can, and Pyra is in. Pyra hip toss into the hold, but GA breaking that up before Pyra could get substantial damage on Yukiko's arm. And now Pyra picking Yukiko up and sending her face first into the corner. And I think Chie was trying to attack Pyra, but it looked like she accidentally hit Yukiko there. Now Pyra knocking Chie off the apron. Yukiko, a nice corner splash there. And is she tired already? Yukiko in the corner, just kind of chilling. Okay, I think she was playing possum there. Mithra finally up on the apron. high kick there by Pyra. But going for the stop, but Yukiko getting out of the way. Spin kick. Now Chie's back on the apron as well. Chie being tagged in. And now Pyro with the Irish whip into the abrupt takedown. Now a kick to the right below the chest. And a spinning kick there. Like a one and a half leg drop kick. And now another hip toss into the arm bar. But this time it is Chie on the receiving end. Yukiko breaking that up, but Pyra gaining advantage and sending Chie, sending Yukiko flying off the apron. And now Mithra picking Chie up. And a choke slam. And now Mithra climbing up top. Turning around. Splash attempt, but Chie seeing that coming and getting out of the way. Sending her into the opposite corner. Now Irish whip into the other corner. Double leg drop kick into the turnbuckle. Going for the pin. Pyra in now. One. Breaking that up, but Yukiko sending Pyra over the top rope. Mithra picking Chie up and slamming her down. Now the women in red are fighting on the outside, leaving Mithra and Chie to fend for themselves on the inside. And now Pyra being sent to the inside, being forced to roll out because she is not the legal partner here. Mithra picking Chie up though in the fireman's carry and sending her neck first against the ropes, and now again looking for a top rope maneuver. This time connecting with the somersault elbow. And now Pyra playing some defense, knocking Yukiko off the apron to try to protect the fall. But Chie kicking out and kicking Mithra in the arm. Now tornado kick to the back connects, going for the pin of Pyra. Raking that up though before the zero count. Now jumping arm breaker, or a stomp to the arm, and a split leg breaker. And Chie taking this two-on-one fully taking this disadvantage two-on-one to a full advantage. With her elbowing out, and now tossing Chie by her head and tagging in Pyra. Yukiko looking for a tag, and gets it. Pyra with a low kick there. Now a backpack suplex into the handstand, a leg or elbow drop, and another into the clubbing strikes to the lower lumbar. And if I was Pyra, I would go for a pin attempt here, with Chie being on the outside, but I guess not. And now sending Yukiko into the clutch, into the corner, and are we going to see our first tag team attack here? Yes, we are. Quadruple leg drop kick. Now Yukiko rolling outside. And the double edge blades, full advantage here. Mithra sending Yukiko back in, much to her displeasure. And head scissor takedown, not going for the pin, instead going for the tag. a sneaky little leg drop there and leg there, or knee strike there. And a possum pin. Well, not quite a possum pin, excuse me, a rebound pin. And I have no idea what Pyro was even attempting to do there. Sending Chie into the corner. Now tossing her. Middle leg, middle rope backflip, excuse me, going for the pin. One, two. Chie getting her shoulder up legitimately. And now Pyro looking for the finisher. Hip toss, armbar locked in. Yukiko breaking that up. Pyra sending Yukiko down that strike. And now is Pyra now attacking Yukiko for whatever reason. Probably just to try to stun her a little bit more. Now rolling in on the outside, and is she looking for... No, Yukiko. Or excuse me, Chie knocking Pyra off the apron, and now attacking Mithra, sending her off the apron. One count, double leg drop kick. And now sending... Excuse me. Yep, sending Chie back in. Pyra rolling in herself. Now, apron, flying, clothesline, one, two. Oh, Yukiko breaking that up right before the three count. Excuse me, that was a forearm, not a clothesline. And again, Pyra locked in, and again, Yukiko breaking that up, but not before Chie could tap out. And the double edge blaze, kidding. A tap out victory, and Yukiko showing off her airbending skills there. And I was wrong, that was actually a pretty decent tag team showing. As we see, I was hoping to see Yukiko show off her airbending skills a little bit more, but nope. And here we go. Double Edge Blaze picking up yet another victory. And we might see them at Against the Odds. We shall see. Our next matchup of the evening, and introducing first, it is the Beast himself, the hero of the Homs, Dunban. It's scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring from the future, weighing in at 200 pounds, the Beast Dunban. Dunban, not a super strong season so far, and I'm a little bit disappointed, but with how stacked the Jayromada men's roster is, getting a win is very hard to come by. You absolutely have to earn it. He's been close several times, but not as many wins as I would expect. And his opponent, it is Yu Narukami. one half of the JWE Jayromada Men's Tag Team Champions. Yu Narukami, I think this is his singles debut. Unless I'm forgetting something, but I believe this is his, I believe this is it. And let's see if he can put on a show worthy of the men's tag team championship belt. Go Dunban versus Yu. Bell rings and they meet in the middle. Dunban immediately getting the offense in with that misdirecting knee strike. Now kick and quick little DDT. And picking Yu up in the fireman's carry. And catching his chest against the ropes. And now knee strikes to the hamstring. And we've seen this with Dunban many, many times. Starting strong, but just unable to get the finish. So, don't be fooled. Suplex there and trying to get Yu back up onto his feet. Leg strike, or knife edge chop into the strike. And an elbow, 12-6 elbow to the shoulder, and a rolling neck breaker. Now Yu rolling out, Dunban following him with that suicide spear connects, almost crashing into the announcer's booth. High kick. And a spinning kick there. A jumping forearm shiver. And now a terminating knee smash. But Yu pushing him and pushing Dunban off of him. That back elbow. Knife edge chop landing on both tables. And a snap DDT on the outside. Referee up to a 6 count already. She is counting extremely quickly. Tossing Dunban into the ring. Yu climbing in, but Dunban trying to grab. And now. Was that the Blossom Dance? Going for the pin. One. Two. Yu kicking out. Now, yes, I believe that was the Blossom Dance. It's been a while since I've seen it. Yu with a very interesting takedown. And now choking Dunban against the ropes, self-censoring for your viewing displeasure. Or pleasure, depends on if you like violence or not. Dunban with a very nice back elbow, a kick into the stunner. And now, is he looking for the Tempest kick? No, against Born in a World of Strife, against the odds, we choose to fight Blossom Dance. Going for the pin. One, two, and Dunban picking up a pretty quick win against Yu, getting it done there. And that is the Dunban that I expect to see week in and week out.
Here is your winner, the Beast Dunban.
And Dunban, is he willing to Or is he on his way to break his cold streak? I don't know, a single win might not be evidence of that, but maybe. Our next matchup between two fighters who we don't see quite often. Introducing first.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making our way to the ring from Kyoto, Japan. Mills Harry Joe.
It is Mitsuru Kojiro. And her opponent, it is Pandoria. The fairly disappointing season so far, but nothing unexpected, I would say. There we go, bell rings, and they meet in the middle with a nice neckbreaker there by Mitsuru. Tossing Pandora into the corner, and a nice corner clothesline stomping on her mid-spine and pulling on Pandy's arm. Now picking Pandy up. And takedown there. A kick, and Mitsuru getting this match very strong. Now Pandora rolling to the outside, Mitsuru trying to get her up. Suicide spear connects. Kicking Pandy back up and tossing her into the corner. Referee all only up to a two count. Now sending Pandy into from one barricade to the other, and now face first. Knife edge chop, kicking Pandora up by the leg and taking her down. And now some mission maneuver here, but that's not gonna do a whole lot. Pandora throwing Mitsuru into the corner, referee already up to 7. Here we go, 8 count now, and they need to get into the ring stat. Mitsuru getting in right before 9, and this match continues. Somersault stunner, and I don't think Mitsuru is supposed to bend like that. Not sure if she's that flexible. Andy, takedown into the armbar, but Mitsuru rolling out, picking Pandora up into the cradle position, but Pandora elbowing herself out, but Mitsuru still tossing her into the corner. but Pandora with a... with the back elbow there, with the reversal, and now rolling neck snap, climbing to the middle rope, begging Mitsuru to climb up onto her feet, and jumping double axe handle. Now dragging Mitsuru into the middle of the ring. Is she looking for a sneaky little pin? No, she is not. Okay, now she is after that standing shooting star. 1, 2. Mitsuru. Jumping out. Now rolling to the outside. Pandora. Climbing back in. Wanting to go up top yet again. And completely whiffing. Not sure if he was like 5 seconds in the past or something, but yeah, no. Mitsuru wasn't there for like quite a while. Corner elbows knocking Pandora down, and now Mitsuru. Not quite insult to injury, too. Pandora kicking out, but a nice backflip landing into that splash. And now figure eight leg lock. Locked in. And Pandora fighting it, trying not to tap out. And gets the ankle off of her. Sending Mitsuru down and kicking her in the spine. Snap mirror into the stunner. Into the rolling neck snap, excuse me. It's kind of a stunner. Slap into the back elbow. Back elbow into the kick. That was stomp right below, or right above in the middle of the lumbar. I was trying to figure out what I wanted to say there, and I completely missed a two count because I cannot select words for some reason tonight. Pandora getting the clutch, sending Mitsuru up top into the spinning takedown. Now picking Mitsuru up, but Mitsuru sending her down, tripping her up, and Pandora rolling out. And is Mitsuru looking for another suicide attack? Yes, she is, and again connects. And the ground and pound, and one more. 4, 5, 6. Eighteen ground and pound punches, and then a suplex to the on the outside. Pandora kicking Mitsuru off of her and taunting her with that, with the shape of an L on her forehead. Well, the years stop coming, but the attacks do stop. The years start coming, and the attacks don't stop coming. Bend to the rules, and you better hit the ground running. Didn't make sense why Pandora slide out again. Resetting it to 1. Sending Mitsuru back in. And now Pandora, is she looking for the phenomenal forearm? No, phenomenal. Head scissor takedown, going for the pin. 1, 2. And Pandora, surprise, surprise, victor. I guess all she needs me to do is a quote all-star and she can get the win. Oh no, that would make sense with her and Zeke, let's be honest.
Here is your winner, Pamela.
That Pandora picking up a surprising but well-deserved victory there. And our next matchup, introducing first, it is Kiyotaka Ishimaru.
The following is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring, representing the Brotherhood from Kyoto, Japan, weighing in at 146 pounds, Kiyotaka Ishimaru.
Being joined ringside by Mondo Iwata, and let's hope that this goes better than last week with Mondo running a little bit of interference that Taka was not too much of a fan of. They had a word with each other last week backstage, and the ice between them staying together and breaking up is getting thinner by the week. At least that's what it seems like.
And his opponent, representing the Brainbusters, from out of this world, weighing in at 250 pounds, the Motor.
And their opponent, it's Ryan time, baby. Can't make a rainbow without Ryan, but you can certainly. You can't even make a match without Ryan. Because he certainly brings the energy, brings the show, and he's probably one of my favorite wrestlers on this roster. Just being fully transparent. But yeah, it's Ryan time. Now, if I was Taka, I would rather have Mondo facing off against Ryan. But that's just me. Because Ryan picks up Taka and sends him neck first into the ropes. And honestly, I'm glad that Ryan is doing much better this season than he did in the beginning of the last. Now face plant. And Ryan picking Taka back up. Some punches there. And Ryan pushing Taka away, taking him down. And now bowing leg drop connects. And another attempt here. But Taka getting out of the way. Nice double leg drop kick there. Picking Ryan up, but Ryan pushing him away into that cross body splash. And I'm not sure. He was debating on whether or not he wants to pin Taka, decides to do it, and it's a one count. Taking Taka up and sending him down with that powerbomb, loading to the crowd as Taka sits in the corner. I think that's the only time he's been sent into the corner by in his life, at least sitting in the corner. He is the ultimate moral compass, after all. Running shimmy leg drop, but Taka getting out of the way. Trying to pick up Ryan, but Ryan punching him. Nice slip with the punch there by Taka, though. And he's making this an event. Kick to the leg. And Ryan with a back elbow. And Taka with a back elbow. Both intercepting each other. Both And Ryan, as soon as I was trying to find the right word, Ryan, with that reversal, that's what I was looking for. Now picking Taka up and sending him from one corner to the other, face first into the turnstile. 1-2. Taka getting his shoulder up. Ryan sending him back down, picking him back up though, and bringing him to Suplex City. Picking Taka up, takedown into the powerbomb. And now rolling Taka onto his back. 1-2. Taka getting his shoulder up. But it's been all Ryan right now. Middle rope. And into the disrespectful kick. But Taka getting out of the way. And a double leg drop kick. Into the stump to the hamstring. But Ryan kicking him off. Stomp to the wrist, stomp to the upper arm. And another bowing leg drop. Picking Taka up and kick into the DDT. And now another shimmy leg drop, this time connects. An exploding powerbomb into the corner. Picking Taka up and sending him into the tree of woe here. And now a corner choke. Kick to the spine, and Taka with a very nice reversal, but Ryan pushing him away. Taka actually getting some offense in, and a pin attempt. 1-2. And Ryan kicking out at 2. Taka stomping him. Kick to the face there, and now a wrist clutch. Now falling fist connects, but elbow drop, Ryan getting out of the way, and a single leg kneeling big boot. Now dragging Taka to the middle of the ring. And now deadlift military, never mind, deadlift suplex. 1-2. Taka getting out. Both men to the outside, and Mondo giving room. Not wanting to play interference. Respecting Taka's wishes from last week. Ryan picking Taka back up and sending him down back first into the mat on the outside. And now sending him face first into the corner. Quick six count. And now catching the legs against the apron. 8. They need to be careful. Ryan sliding in. Now sliding out. Crossbody, but somehow Taka caught that. And a pendulum backbreaker into a stomp to the wrist. Ryan sending him into the barricade, just tumbling shoulder first. Ryan stepping in and taunting Taka a little bit. Taka's at the seven count, slow to get up onto his feet, but sliding in at eight, only to be met by Ryan looking for the wild. Nope, I thought he was looking for the wild down. No, he is just looking for the snake eyes. Taka with a nice reversal from the corner, but whiffing on that punch. Ryan sending him into the corner. And what is Ryan thinking here? Backwards splash. And now Ryan looking for the wild down. Picking Taka up. And wild down powerbomb, going for the pin. One, two, and Taka unable to kick out. Being pinned, and Mondo climbing in. And now having some words for Taka, and now Taka pushing Mondo away, and now we're seeing it spill out into the ring. And let's see where this takes. Let's see where this goes. Chihiro is going to have to do a lot of therapist. He's going to have to play a lot of therapist if he wants to patch this up. Our next matchup of the evening, introducing first, it is the Bewitching Witch herself, Bayonetta.
Making her way to the ring, from wherever she won, Bayonetta.
Making her way to the ring here, and again, just having a stellar season that hopefully we'll end up in a championship win one of these weeks, one of these pay-per-view events. And her opponent, it is the JWE Jayromada Women's Universal Champion, A2. And oop, that breaks the illusion. Yeah, A2. Making her way to the ring here, and as I said in the intro, holding on tightly to this women's division with an iron... No, iron's too weak. Tungsten grip? Steel? Vibranium? Indestructium? Whatever's like, whatever hardest metal you can think of. It's not even close to the grip that A2 has on this division. bell rings and A2 again and just immediately begin the offense, but Bayonetta with a nice 12-6 elbow. Or 12-6 elbow, excuse me. And A2 picking Bayonetta up. Delayed suplex here. And taking her down. What immaculate strength there, especially like this early on into the match. Actually, no, that's when you're at your strongest. Never mind. Stiletto to the face there, and now just dragging Bayonetta's face against the mat. And now A2 climbing up top. Diving elbow drop, but Bayonetta getting out of the way. And I believe this is a rematch of the second round of the Tournament of Champions. When is the last time I talked about that? A2 getting out of the way of that jumping roundhouse kick into a jumping roundhouse knee. One. Bayonetta kicking out. And I believe it was Bayonetta who came out victorious at during that meeting. A2 will obviously be looking to turn that around, and I'm pretty sure they've met multiple times since then. Roaring uppercut to the back of the head there is A2 from one corner to another end. Just, yeah, clotheslining Bayonetta into the corner. Stomp to the hand, and now picking Bayonetta up and powerbomb into the corner. Bayonetta rolling out. A2 following her and tossing her back in. Sliding in again, and now A2 already has the finisher on lock. Bayonetta getting out of the way. And a nice high kick there, but A2 sending Bayonetta into the referee, and a nice reversal. Picking Bayonetta up and looking for the chokeslam, but Bayonetta getting out of the way with that reversal. Now arm toss into the ropes, A2 rolling out, climbing back in, Bayonetta climbing out and climbing back in. Now A2 sending Bayonetta into the corner, jumping knee strike. And now another wind-up uppercut to the back of Bayonetta's skull, and again just dragging her face against the mat. And this is what I've been saying. Like, A2 has just been unstoppable as of late. Bayonetta crawling to the crawling to the apron. A2 looking to knock her off, but Bayonetta with that reversal and botching that, but still connecting. Now A2 picking Bayonetta back up and running a running high kick. Now A2 again looking for a finisher. And the Styles Clash connects. Going for the pin, rolling her up. One, two. Bayonetta kicking out. A2 again, and a pendulum backbreaker. And picking Bayonetta up. And a powerbomb middle of the ring. And Bayonetta just can't. She just doesn't have an answer. At least not yet. Getting out of the way of that middle rope spear, though. And a half hitch knee raise. No handstand choke. And maybe Bayonetta can make a comeback here. Jumping knee strike connects, taking A2 back up onto her feet. And even more half hitch knee raises. And dropping neck breaker. Is Bayonetta? Yes, Bayonetta is gonna go for the pin. One, two, A2 kicking out. Rolling out of the way of that stomp attempt, but Bayonetta getting out of the way of that running punch. And an axe kick. A2 rolling out. And Bayonetta rolling onto her side to taunt. And what a complete turnaround this has been. It was A2 all the way. And then Bayonetta just turning the tides. A2 not really having much to answer right now. Except with that reversal. Commentator's curse, I swear, every time I say, it was like a lot of times I say one thing, I'm immediately disproven. And Bayonetta looking for another neckbreaker connects, and another pin. One, two. A2 with that resiliency though. Hip toss, and now Bayonetta top rope, looking to put a bow on this match, but A2 getting out of the way. Now picking Bayonetta up, stomping her down with that right foot, and powerbomb again. Bayonetta up slowly to her feet. Now A2 working on that arm. Irish whip into the spinning takedown. And now the ground and pound. Now top rope here. Bayonetta getting up onto her feet. A2 jumping cart or a jumping windmill clothesline too. And somehow Bayonetta kicks out. Now A2 looking for another Styles Clash. Has it locked in? Connects. Another pin here, but very unfortunate rope break. Probably should have rolled the other way. Picking Bayonetta up. But Bayonetta with that reversal. Now knee strike into the axe hand or into the axe kick. And I think this is the first time that we've seen Bayonetta's stomps there. You know, Bayonetta picking A2 up and neckbreaker onto the shoulder. Picking A2 back up onto her feet though. And another neckbreaker attempt. And again it connects. And again looking for the pin. One, two, and A2 is not going to kick out of this one. Bayonetta picking up that victory. And I think that's two in a row for A2 right now. I think she lost to 2B last week. And maybe that grip is slipping a little bit. And ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. Introducing first, still undefeated, and still in that outfit, it is Goro Akechi. And who can deliver Akechi his first loss? That is still yet to be answered. The men's Universal Champion putting on an absolute clinic. And he seems absolutely unstoppable. Absolutely unstoppable as of right now. And his opponent, it is Rexrex. I believe this is his... is it a singles debut? I forget, but yeah, Rex not super used to singles matches here. But I don't know, let's see if he's a bit of an underdog here. Bell rings and Akechi immediately running towards Rex, but Rex immediately getting out of the way and sending him down with that elbow drop. And again with that neck breaker. Rex on the outside, but jumping in, and speaking of jumping, RKO out of nowhere. But Rex, nice back elbow. Oh, not quite in range for that springboard double leg drop kick. To catch you with that high kick. Knife edge chops and bringing Rex down. But Rex with a nice punch into the corner. Bringing Akechi down. And rolling neck breaker. That shot whiffed, and Akechi looking to be a little bit fancy there, but Rex catching him. And another springboard rolling neckbreaker. Rex is just keeping it simple, and maybe that's what you need to do against Akechi. Bowing leg drop connects. and springboard Superman forearm actually connects this time. You know, trying to get Akechi to run towards him, and he does, like a bull to a matador. Rex getting out of the way and dropping Akechi. And a very strong start from the hero of All Rest. And now Rex just clearing off some furniture because he feels like it. And a nice reversal. Picking Akechi up. And now dragging him to the apron, or bringing him to the apron, carrying him, that's what I'm looking for, to the apron, and a nice apron powerbomb from the outside. Springboard double leg dropkick actually connects his time, going for the pin a little bit early in the match. 1, 2. Catchy with an early 2 count though, rolling out of the way. But Rex with a nice block. And again, just a very simple springboard double leg dropkick. As simple as a double leg dropkick off the ropes can be. Rex with a nice takedown there. And Akechi throwing Rex down, whiffing on that double leg dropkick of his own. That is a fun word. That is a fun string of words to say. Rex bringing Akechi down. Now on the outside, jumping in, just trying to get the adrenaline, just trying to keep the blood pumping. Both on the outside. Akechi rolling in, Rex rolling in as well. Akechi with that high kick. And now rolling neckbreaker, and I think playtime might be over for Rex. Akechi is done messing around. The crow climbing up top, looking to fly, spreading his wings and connecting. Going for the pin. 1, 2. Rex getting his shoulder up. Jumping knee strike as Rex is laying down prone. But Rex trying to get out of that, and Akechi lighting up. And now tuning up the band, looking for the sweet chin music. Connects, going for the pin. 1, 2. And I was going to say Rex put up a very good fight, but he's still putting up a very good fight because he got his shoulder up. And Rex with a reversal there, tripping Akechi up, looking to go for the grab, but Akechi rolling out of the way, and now Irish Whip into the jumping punch. 1. Only 1 count this time. Rex slow to get up onto his feet with a nice roll there. And jumping shoulder, but Akechi quick to get up onto his feet. Suplex by Rex. Suprex. Sure, let's go with that. Rex tripping Akechi up and locking his ankle in for a possible submission attempt. Or it is a submission attempt, but Akechi punching his way out. Rolling neckbreaker takedown. Now take... and Rex just taking Akechi down, and another hip toss into a headlock. But Akechi pushing him off of him. Rex on the outside again. Phenomenal forearm connects. Going for the pin. Trying to protect Akechi from grabbing that rope, but Akechi kicking out. Akechi with a possum kick, but Rex pushing him away, and a backpack takedown. Now soccer ball kick off that rebound, and now Rex climbing up top, looking to fly just like the crow did, and does spread his wings and a cross by splash, picking Akechi back up. And a bicycle kick there. On the outside, is he looking for another phenomenal forearm? Yes, he is. And again, he connects. Rex putting up an extremely good fight here. One, two. And it's so good of a fight that Akechi finally breaks his winning streak. Or Rex breaks his winning streak. And now can't believe it. And what? I can't see it. Okay. And here comes Eggman looking to put some insult to injury here, picking Akechi up and putting him down with that choke slam. And that is the frustrations of everyone in the men's division of Jayromada, in that single choke slam and that victory. And Akechi, his house of cards might be falling here, and he ain't the Joker. Thank you all for joining us on this edition of Jayromada. We hope to see you next Wednesday for Wingcrest and Friday for Eclipse, and in just a few weeks time it will be the inaugural Against the Odds pay-per-view event. I'm certain you don't want to miss it. Until then, we're signing out from Green Bay, Wisconsin, where so much has happened tonight. I hope to see you in the next one. Until then, take care. See ya.